Hello, friends. I'm here in Marietta, Georgia, which is just outside of Atlanta, or should I say Hotlanta, because it's really, really hot here. Anyway, today we're going to learn about UL environment and some of the tests that are done here at this lab. It's really hot, so let's just go inside, okay? Come on, let's go. Kevin? Kevin, it's closed. Let me in, man. Dude, it's hot out here. It's like 90 degrees in the shade. Kevin! So now I'm in the Chambers Laboratory here in Marietta, and I'm here with Elliot. Say hi, Elliot.
Hi, Elliot.
So Elliot, tell me, what do you do here at UL Environment?
Well, there are a couple of things that I'm involved in here. We do some testing of materials for use in clean room situations. We also test medical devices for respiratory assistance. And we also test some pieces of furniture and wood products for whether or not formaldehyde emissions are above a certain level.
Okay, now why is this so important?
Well, start with the clean room. There are very important manufacturing facilities which can be harmed by very small amounts of microscopic dust particles. So materials and devices that are used in these facilities need to be tested to make sure they're not releasing any particles which could interfere with the manufacturing process and incur large economic losses to the manufacturing facilities.
Okay, great. Is it okay if we see like some of the tests that have been done?
What we have here are pieces of either flooring or furniture, such as the bottom of a drawer or the back of a chest of drawers. They've been cut out and we put them in our small chambers and measure the formaldehyde emissions that result from these samples being placed in the chambers.
Ultimately, what we're looking for in order to receive a passing grade is a certain level of formaldehyde or
yes.
No formaldehyde
yes.
At all.
There are, well, we'd like to have no formaldehyde at all, but when it's going to be in there in a lot of these engineered wood materials, so it's a matter of how much is being emitted. And yes, there are regulatory levels for the formaldehyde emission rates that have to be met to be legally sold in the United States.
Okay, wow, that's interesting information to know, and this is potentially saving lives, and that's what we want to do.
Yes.
Okay, great, thank you so much, Elliot. This is really helpful, thank you.
Thank you.
So I'm in the HPLC lab here at the UL lab in Marietta, and I'm here with Allison. Say hi, Allison.
Hi, Allison.
So Allison, can you tell me what you do here at UL?
Yes, so what we're doing is we're trying to find specific chemicals within our samples that we take in the Chambers lab. So this is an HPLC.
Okay.
What it does is it separates each individual chemical through the column, and we're able to test and tell you how much is in there.
Now, is it your job then to like move these things around or to...
This whole instrument is automated, as you can see right here. It's picking up the extracted sample and it will inject it into the system. So each one runs by itself
okay.
on automation.
Now, why is all of this important?
This is important because we want to make sure that these chemicals that could be coming out of different samples aren't in your home and you're not breathing them.
Oh, okay. So we're looking for things that are potentially harmful when we breathe them or that fall on our skin?
Yes.
Oh, okay. And that's what these machines do. They look for those specific chemicals?
Yes.
Okay. Perfect. And how long does it take then for all of this to go through or all of this to happen?
Well, we tend to run one throughout the night. Our run is about 20 minutes
okay.
For one sample, and we could have anywhere from about 30 to 120 samples in a day.
Wow, okay, yeah. So this is a very, very busy laboratory.
Yes.
Okay, well, Allison, thank you so much for showing this to us.
You're welcome.
So this is the LCD chamber here at the Marietta Lab, and this is the biggest chamber in the building. You could put all kinds of stuff in here. We can put medical equipment or large furniture or large machines even, or even, if you take a look, we could even fit ourselves in there. So come on, if you want to check it out. Actually, it's a little scary in here. Kevin, take a look. Let us know what you think, all right? Have fun, see you later. This will teach Kevin not to lock me out of the lab. Though it looks like a big mirror room, you might see a product or device placed in this LCD chamber, where clean air is pumped in and air samples are collected and then taken to the HPLC lab for analysis. So that's the inside of the LCD chamber. Other chambers are just like this, only a lot smaller, but they do pretty much the exact same work. Want to learn more? Let's go check it out. So here now I'm in the product emissions lab here in Marietta, and I'm here with Mark. Say hi, Mark.
Hi, Mark.
Why do they always do this? I don't understand. So Mark, what do we have here? There seems to be a lot of metal. What is this for?
Well, each one of these is one of our test chambers. And each one of these test chambers we use in order to gather emissions of chemicals from different products that we're testing.
Okay. Now, is that your job? Is that what you do here to manage all the chambers?
Well, part of my job is preparing the samples to go into chambers and also to take air samples of the air going through them. But another part of my job is to make sure that all of the chambers keep working so that we can trust the data that we're getting.
Oh, wow. Okay. Now, why is this type of testing so important?
Well, this testing is important because we want to understand what chemicals are coming off of the products that we're putting in our homes. What we do in our product emissions lab is we take a look at what chemicals are coming off of the products that we put in our homes every day so that we know whether or not they're safe for people to use. All right, so when you look inside these chambers, you see it's all made out of high polished stainless steel so that the sides of the chambers aren't actually holding on to any of the chemicals. And that means that we don't have to worry about chemicals from one product that we tested affecting the test for the next product that goes into this chamber.
Okay.
It also makes it much easier to clean.
So today here in the UL lab in Marietta, we learned about VOCs, we learned about toxicity, we went to the chem lab, we saw chambers, we learned a lot today. But most importantly, we learned that it's so important to breathe clean air and why there's people here in Marietta that are so dedicated to make sure that the chemicals that come out of products that we use every day is safe. It's really important work, and I'm glad we're here to learn more about it. For UL Safety Smart, I'm Dennis Avalar, and that's how you learn.
Kevin, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, ready? Go ahead.
That was pretty close to the camera.